Hey, how we react to negative people and negative events that happen in our lives is everything, and it's going to affect the rest of our lives. When we let people take up space in our mind and let people bring us down and make us feel, rage and stuff, it takes away from our own selves. And that's why I wanted to talk a little bit about not letting people take up space in your head, not always reacting negatively to text messages. I think everyone would agree that's one of the biggest things that is really easy to take the wrong way too. But some people can really they can really slam people on text or come out wrong. And I've learned over time to not react negatively to texts, right? If someone comes at me wrong, I'm gonna come back at them with, some love still. I'm not gonna come back at them wrong because I don't want people taking up the, my heart's open. I want to love. I want, I'm a compassionate person. I care. And that's who I want to surround myself with, right? So I feel more for people than anything now, because they're not gonna have, because their lives are not gonna be full of abundance and happiness when all they do is concentrate on hurting other people, bringing other people down, holding people down, say even a, like, or abusing people, abusing anything, anybody like that's sick in their low lives, right? I mean, I usually don't say things like that, but the biggest thing is not beating the shit out of ourselves too. But you know how we all are raised. That we see our parents reacting to negative events happening in their lives, and or people negatively coming at them. All our fathers tell us to, it's the way you get brought up too. Never let anybody, I don't think anybody out there should ever let anybody have a spit in their face or anything else. Obviously, you got to protect yourself. But if you can brush off stuff without getting in the anger and start getting resentful and stuff, it's so worth it. So you feel so much more free. I used to react negatively to everything. It wouldn't take much to get me hyped up. Take me the wrong way. I've always been a sensitive person, but now I don't let myself react negatively to text messages that kind of slam me from family and friends or whatever, especially family. Instead, I leave my heart open, and I don't. It's either don't say anything back or I send love back. But yeah, love you too. You gotta think that person is acting like that, or the people out there that you know that are always being negative and stuff. They're not gonna live their life is not gonna be. It's gonna be very predictable. It's not gonna be a great life. They're gonna be miserable all the time. No, I'm sure everyone can relate. If every day is full of hecticness and hate and resentment and stuff, or if you're thinking about it every day, it's going to bring you down. What you want to do is leave that stuff in the past. Leave past problems in the past. I'm not saying go hang out with people that brought this stuff, into your life. But try to stay away from negative people, places, and things. And try to not react negatively to text messages or someone gossiping behind your back. Anything, I don't care what it is, try to give that, because it gives you a peace of mind, so it doesn't mess up your whole day, because these things can really bring us down. But I hope everyone's doing good. I just wanted to do a little Q&A about this. So please subscribe if you can. And again, my name is Derek Nickerson. I'm even open to doing live video calls with you if you need, or if you have any questions about anything. And I'm just getting started with this channel. There's gonna be a lot more stuff, and I appreciate you guys watching. Again, try to stay out of your head, and try to not react negatively to text messages. Send love back, ignore it, and see how much it affects your day. Try to stay out of your head about it too. Forget about it. Just leave in the past. Forget about them. Concentrate on what you want in your life. Abundance and happiness and success. Bye.